What you just saw there was one of the tests we offer, and which is quite commonly found at the universities when newcomers start, the freshies start. It's called glandular fever, or the kissing disease. Right? It's also called Epstein-Barr virus, and it's basically a spot test. Not many tests which do are manually. Unfortunately, that test we have to still do manually. Okay? And it will tell you as if somebody is positive or negative. Okay? The actual test involves a butination method. And as you saw in the picture, there was five which were just milk and liquid, whereas one, which is number two, had agglutination. And that means it's a positive test. What agglutination is, it's latex particles coated with an antigen. If you have the virus, the antigen and the virus will cause agglutination of the latex particles. There is no treatment for glandular fever, but what you have is swollen glands. You feel like you've got flu for about 10 years. You feel really, really absolutely shattered. Normally it's not a problem, but it's when you get to the exam times, you'll be not well. You also get something called, the test is done on a full blood count, a pink bottle. What you will see within that sample is you'll get lymphocytosis. Also something which is predominantly found in glandular fever positive patient is atypical lymphocytes, which are reactive lymphocytes. Okay. And what we will do is when we see a positive glandular fever test, we'll always do a blood film on it. So a morphology will be looked at to see the presence of atypical lymphocytes, which will be indicative of glandular fever. We can also get abnormal liver function test, which is part of the way the virus works, which can affect your liver. Okay? It is a young person's or a teenage condition, but we have also seen elderly patients come up with the condition, and we could never understand why. But the theory from the laboratory perspective is most probably teenagers within the family hugging and kissing grandparents, and they've never had the disease before, and they pick it up. Now, it's okay for young people to have this disease, but in elderly, it may be life-threatening as well.